Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to create a PDF digital signature using the Syncfusion Blazor PDF library. I will also explain how to customize the signature appearance, certify signature, and add a timestamp. Also, I will demonstrate how to use different hashing algorithms, add multiple signatures, and retrieve the existing signature from the document. First, I open an existing Blazor server application, where I have already added the Syncfusion PDF library and created a simple PDF document. I am going to add a digital signature to an existing PDF document. So, let me remove this PDF document creation code from the Export Service class and plan to load the existing PDF file in this application. If you want to know how to get started with the Syncfusion PDF library, please refer to the video link in the card above. Here, I retrieve the file location using the web hosting environment variable and read it as a file stream from the specified location. Then I create an instance of the PDF loaded document class and initialize it with the file stream object. To create the digital signature, I need to obtain a digital ID. This information is stored in a file with the .pfx extension in Windows OS. So, I read this file in a file stream. If you want to know how to create this digital ID in detail, refer to the link provided in the card above. To add a digital signature, you need a certificate with private keys. So, define an object for PDF certificate class and pass the PFX file stream and its password. Then, I create a PDF signature instance with the arguments such as the PDF document instance, the PDF page instance, the PDF certificate, and the name for the signature. Okay, I have added a signature, so now let's proceed to see the output of this code. See here, in the signature panel, the details of the signature are listed. The signature is marked as valid since I have already registered it in the trusted source in Adobe Reader. Also, you need to register the self-signed digital ID in a trusted source in your application. To know more about this, refer to the link in the card above. Notice here, the signature is not visible on the PDF page. To make it visible, it is necessary to set the bounds to the signature. Let's see how to achieve this. The signature object has an API called bounds, and I initialize it to draw on the PDF page. To enhance the signature appearance, I am planning to add an image, so read that image using the file stream object. And create a PDF image by passing the file stream object to from stream API of PDF image class. Also, I define a standard font with name and size to display the text in custom style. Next, I will proceed to draw the signature on the PDF page, which involves drawing text, shape, or image using the signature instance. As a first thing, I draw a rectangle shape. And draw the image within it. Then, draw the text that describes the signature. I have completed customizing the signature. So, let's see the output of this code. Look here, the image and text are added for the signature. Next, let's proceed to see about the digital signature standard and hashing algorithm. By default, the Syncfusion PDF library generates digital signatures with CMS standard and SHA-256 hashing algorithm. I want to change the digital signature standard to CADES, so set the value in the cryptographic standard property of PDF signature settings. And set the hashing algorithm to SHA-512 using the digest algorithm property. Now, let me save and run the application to see the changes in the signature field. In the PDF document, I click the signature field and select the advanced properties inside the signature properties. Here, you can see the hash algorithm and PADS signature level is set. Next, I will show you how to certify signature. Certifying is usually done by the author or creator of the document before it's published, or sent for additional signatures, or form completion. And this can be done only once to the PDF document. To certify signature, I set the certificated property to true. And set the permissions for the certificated document to allow form fills and comments. Also, I plan to add timestamp to the digital signature. So, using the timestamp server API, I add the timestamp server link to the signature. Let's take a look at how the certified signature appears in the PDF document. See here, this signature is marked as certified in the signature panel. And I only allowed to comment and form fill. You can see the timestamp details inside the advanced signature properties. So far, I have shown you how to add a single signature and customize it. But you can also add multiple digital signatures in a PDF document by appending additional signatures to an already signed PDF file. To achieve this, I simply need to follow the steps I discussed earlier for adding a signature. To add another signature, I have to save the document and load that again. To do this, I first create a memory stream and save the document to it. Then, let me close the document instance. Once it is done, I reload the stream in a new document instance. Like the first signature, let me create a PDF certificate using the PFX file test agreement. And create a new signature using the new PDF certificate. Okay, I have added the second signature successfully. Check now, there are two signatures in the signature panel. Second signature is the invisible signature since I have not added any customization. Finally, I am going to show you how to retrieve signature information from an existing PDF document. To do that, in the Create PDF method before adding a second signature, I will get the first signature information and create a PDF loaded signature field instance to get the signature field from the document form field collection. Then, get the PDF signature instance from the signature property of the signature field. Using this signature instance, I can retrieve various details such as certificate details, signature standard, hashing algorithm, and more. Here I am going to retrieve the signature standard and hashing algorithm and store them in different variables. And use those values for the second signature. Let's see the final output of this code. Open the properties panel of signature 1 and the hash algorithm is SHA-512 and PADS signature level is BT. Next, open the properties of signature 2, and you will see the same set of properties. Here the signature level is BB. Since signature 1 has timestamp details, it is mentioned as BT. But signature 2 does not have it, so it is mentioned as BB. Let me recap what I have shown so far. I showed you how to create a digital signature, customize its appearance, and certify signature. I also showed how to use different hashing algorithms, and add a timestamp, and multiple signatures to the document. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.